Boom, 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 boom. I'm gonna shoot you right down, right off of your feet. Take you home with me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go home. Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go home.
Does he love me? I wanna know. How can I tell if he loves me so? Is it in his eyes?
Oh, no.
Bright light, baby.
Because you don't know my mind.
We're gonna romp and trump till midnight. We're gonna fuss and fight till daylight. We're gonna beat you wang dang doodle all night long. All night long.
VJ Records was the most successful black-owned and operated record company before Motown. Founded in 1953 by Vivian Carter, the V, and her husband, James Jimmy Bracken, the J, in Gary, Indiana, VJ contributed a tremendous catalog of blues, rhythm and blues, doo-wop, jazz, soul, pop, and rock and roll music. The label started as an outgrowth of the Brackens' successful record shop and Vivian's stint as a disc jockey at WGRY in Gary. The black music Vivian was playing on her radio show at the time was not generally available on records. The Brackens decided to start recording some of these artists, and VJ was born. The couple felt that they could get a label together that could get radio play and sales through their broadcasting and retail contacts. The first artists signed to the label were the Spaniels and Jimmy Reed. In a 1981 interview, first published in Goldmine, Calvin Carter, Vivian's brother, said Vivian and Jimmy borrowed $500 to produce the first record and borrowed it from a pawn shop. The pawnbroker's name was Maurice Tepper. James Bracken was born in Oklahoma on May 23, 1909, grew up in Kansas City, Kansas, and attended Western University in Quindaro, Kansas. He was living in Chicago when he met Vivian Carter in 1914. Carter was born in Tunisia, Mississippi in 1920 and moved to Gary, Indiana as a little girl. She graduated from Roosevelt High in 1939. In 1948, in Chicago, she won a talent contest for new DJs conducted by Al Benson. She worked 3 months at WGES and then moved to WJOB in her hometown of Gary. Carter and Bracken became business partners in 1950 when they founded Vivian's Record Shop in Gary. After 3 years of saving their money, in mid-1953, they decided to start their own record company. Meanwhile, Vivian continued DJing in Gary, joining WGRY in 1952 and moving to WWCA in 1954, which was undoubtedly a significant factor in attracting talent to their label.
According to Old Town Records executive Sam Weiss, VJ came the closest to becoming the number one black-owned pop label. They penetrated the white market like a cannonball through butter. Had they overcome the family and financial problems that ultimately destroyed them, they would have become as big as Motown. By late 1963, however, the label was threatened by a rash of lawsuits.